Turns out it was a 27-year-old street vendor who was the one who blew himself up after climbing aboard a bus of the presidential guard. Well, to talk about it, we're in the company of Mohsen Marzouk, Secretary General of the ruling Nida Tounes Party. Thank you for being with us here.
Thank you for having me.
On France 24. Now, there's a parallel to be drawn between Paris and Tunis. The orders, perhaps, came from abroad, but the perpetrators, the ones carrying out the attack, are local citizens.
Yeah, I mean, it's war at the let's say international level, at the regional level. So I mean, those who are planning, they may be not Tunisian, but those who are perpetrating this could be Tunisian, and the opposite could happen in different regions in the world. The most important fact, I mean, part is that we are having a war against us, and we have to be able to accept additional attacks, unfortunately. And we should be able to strike also, and we should reorganize ourselves for long-term war. It will maybe take for us a few years, because the situation in Libya is quite difficult, but the situation also in the whole region is quite difficult. And we have to conduct this war with the rationale of war and with the means of war.
But again, this is the difficulty for many, is that you say the word war, but part of that war is against our own citizens. In my case, French, in your case, Tunisian.
I don't know if we can really consider them citizens. I mean, these people are, let's say, fighting the state, fighting the Tunisians. They are not all Tunisians. Some of them are from other nationalities. And the Shambi Mount, we'll find Tunisian, you'll find Nigerian, you'll find, let's say, people from Mauritania, maybe from Algeria. So it's an international corp who is, let's say, striking and conducting all these attacks. So when we see a war, it should be considered war. If we consider it as just, let's say, an organized crime, then we will not be able to have the right answers.
But calling it a war, isn't that what they want?
I think the issue is not now to ask ourselves what the terrorist wants. It's what the terrorists are doing. And what they're doing is they are using weapons, they're killing citizens, they are being organized, they have plans. There is a state behind them, which is ISIS. And the war they're conducting have, let's say, a huge front. Tunisia, Libya, Syria, Iraq, France, maybe the USA, maybe the UK. So this is, for them, it's a real war against us, and we have to accept it and assume it as a war. Otherwise, we'll not have the right answer to this.
All right, Mohsen Marzouk, many thanks for joining us here.
Thank you. Yeah.